First, giving honor to our Lord and our Savior, who is the author and the finisher of our faith, to Reverend Dr. Phillips and to the Greater St. James AME Church family, I bring you greetings all the way from Dillard University as we come to celebrate on this Mother's Day, but also Baccalaureate Sunday, where we celebrate our graduates as they have completed a milestone. And I don't take it robbery to be before you on today, but you know, one of the things we celebrate our mothers, especially those biological, adopted godmoms, stepmom, beloved moms, hated moms, but most importantly, we celebrate our mothers. Be it good, bad, or indifferent, if it wasn't for mothers, we wouldn't be here today. And so we give God praise for the opportunity to lift up and to celebrate our mothers. And I don't know about the mothers that are here, but I know for my mom, the biggest gift that I could give was for her to have my degree after she didn't put 4 years of sweat and tears, amen? And so today we give God praise for the labor. And if anything, a passport that will lead you into a life and a legacy of something that is even richer, far reaching than you could ever imagine, if you will just allow yourself to use it for the glory of God as you continue to go forth to the next chapter of your life. But if you would be so gracious to pause with me as we just take a moment just to pray and allow God to lead, guide, and direct us as only God can do, because even COVID-19 has nothing on praying to the God who hears us when we cry unto him. Amen? Amen. Let us pray. I need thee, oh, I need thee.
Guess what? As you're graduating, you are now getting a stamp in your passport.
passport, your life passport. In other words, it's going to give you access to some things. But the question is, do you understand your purpose in fulfilling that which God has purposed you for to move to the next level? But understand something, beloved, that this is not something that's going to be in vain. It's not something that's going to be wasted, because Romans reminds us all things are working together for the good of them that are loved and called according to God's purpose, God's plans for your life. Right. In other words, beloved, guess what? Even COVID-19 has something in store for you. In other words, if you look for the silver lining in the midst of the great cloud, you will find it. But the question is, do you really want to find it?
All right.
But it's about you embracing your purpose in this season. It's not about your semester being flat foot busted and disgusted. The question is, did you finish? If you finish the rope, guess what? If you finish the race, nobody can take that away from you. And so you now have access to move to the next place that God has destined for you. For some of them are worrying and concerned. In other words, where I'm going to do, what I'm going to do. But guess what? You don't have to worry about that, because if you know who has the plans that have already been laid out for you, if you know who has the purpose already clear about what he made you for, you don't have nothing to worry about. So when we begin looking at this word purpose, so many times we get so caught up in feelings. It's not about feeling, it's about what you know. And one of the things that I love about my Jesus, he was clear. Even when he was born in a manger, he was clear. Even stepping out of time into eternity, he was clear of his purpose. And God began to reaffirm that. Even as he went down into the water and he told John, I need you to baptize me. He said, no, you should be baptizing me. I'm clear about what my purpose is. You need to baptize me so that I can be affirmed in what my Father is calling me to do. And even in that moment when John goes to baptize him, he comes up out of the water and God begins to confirm who he is. This is my beloved whom I'm well pleased. And so, my brothers and sisters, if nothing else, you need to understand on this day that you are a part of the beloved community, that God is well pleased. And if God loves you, and know that if God loves you, you don't have nothing to worry about. Guess what? God loves you, so you have nothing to worry about. Even though you may hear rumors of war and pestilence and things of this nature, but if you are on God's side, you don't have anything to worry about.
Amen.
Now, don't get it wrong. You will have some trials and tribulation. Even yes. Jesus said, he prayed that to his disciples, and I pray that your faith will not fail you, but that you will hold on. So I'm praying that you will continue to hold on as you embrace your purpose to move to the next level in God.
Amen.
So when you begin to look at the word purpose, it means understanding. In spiritual terms, you need to have an understanding of God's purpose for your life. When you're moving along, it's not about what your friends are thinking. It's not about what mama and daddy is thinking. It's about what you know God is calling you to in this next season of your life. And one of the things that I love about Mother's Day is that it celebrates how even Jesus' mama had to hold on to some things even as Jesus was growing up. It said that she pondered those things in her heart that was being revealed to her about her beloved child. And guess what, beloved? There's some things that your mama can tell you about you that you can't even tell about yourself. But if you listen to the wisdom that she was sharing, because it comes out of a place of love, care, and concern, she could bend and help direct you into your purpose. You don't believe me? Go back to the wedding at the well. She had already known. She knew who this child was. And so she went and told them, look, we at this wedding. They're running out of water. I want Jesus to come and turn this water into wine. And she goes and gets Jesus. And Jesus goes and does what she tells them to do. And in the midst of he doing what she tells him to do, something happened. They get the best wine they ever had. Because she held on to those things that she encountered along the way. So guess what? There's some things that your mom has already hidden in your heart that God revealed unto her along the way. But the question is, are you willing to listen?
Yes.
But even in that, he kind of rebuked and said, woman, it ain't time for that. You got to know when it's time to move and fulfill your purpose.
Yes, sir.
And so here is an understanding of what God has for your life. In other words, beloved, we all have something. Everything has a particular purpose that is linked to a greater purpose. You have a greater purpose. No, I don't understand why in the world I would leave Washington, D.C. It's all calm and the whole night, and then I step into hell in the midst of corona. I don't understand, but God has a purpose and a plan for it all. But I know that at the end of the day, God is the one who is ordering my steps. The steps of a righteous man or woman is ordered by God. Because God has a purpose and a plan. Remember, he tells Jeremiah, I know the thoughts. I know the plans that I have for you, says the Lord. And so, beloved, as you move forward, you got to understand everything.
everything has a particular purpose that is linked to a greater purpose. Point number one, everything, not some things, everything. The good, the bad, the ugly, the happy, and the sad. The yes. good, the bad, the happy, and the sad. Everything has a purpose.
Yes.
The question is, do you even think about your purpose? Mm-hmm. And for so long, you've been living your life according to everybody else. What about you embracing the purpose that God has for you? That's going to require you to do something different. It's going to require you to have to look to the hills, knowing that your help is going to come from the Lord and the Lord above.
Yes, sir.
But everything has a particular purpose that is linked to a greater purpose. And I want you to take a battery, for instance. The purpose of a battery is to store energy until it is needed. If the battery is never placed into a position that requires its stored energy, it cannot fulfill its purpose. Right. In other words, a satisfaction of purpose is related to its position in a product that has a larger purpose. You're missing what I'm saying. In other words, God has something purpose for you. There's yes. something inside yes. of you, but if you don't get in the right position, you can't release it. Mm-hmm. In other words, so a car battery cannot fulfill its purpose unless you turn the key in the ignition and allow the battery to send power to the engine, which starts the engine that powers the wheels and moves the car. Without the other parts, wait a minute now, neither the battery, the engine, the wheels, nor the car can fulfill that purpose. Okay, preacher, what you mean? Everything that you're going through, you're not going through it for yourself. You're going through it because you're going to be connected to somebody else who needs you to link up to create your purpose, to fulfill your purpose. It's kind of like these stained glass windows in the church. In other words, you've got a big, beautiful picture there, but if you don't take time to connect the colors or the design, then you don't get the beautiful picture. In other words, your purpose is a part of the grand scheme of God. In other words, you got your passport to move into your purpose, but your purpose is not an insular thing, it's a collective thing. And so everything needs something. The world needs you. The world needs you and your purpose for which you were born. You also need the purpose of others in order to fulfill your purpose. Purpose cannot be fulfilled in isolation. Don't you allow the world, even though COVID is telling you you can't touch somebody, you can't connect with somebody, for the devil is a liar. You will need each and everybody you come in contact with, the good, the bad, the happy, and the sad. All of it is going to help to create what God is calling his kingdom here on earth right now.
All right.
And so the same phenomenon of independent purpose, according to Miles Monroe, is the evident in the church. The Apostle Paul uses the image of the physical body to describe the interrelatedness. He said, for just as each of us have one body with many members, and these members do not all have the same function, so is it we in Christ, though many for one body, each member belongs all to the others. So don't fall into that trap as you're graduating into the American dream of trying to make America great again. You better fall back into, it takes a village to raise up a child. It takes yeah. a village for all of us to move into our next destiny, into our purpose to fulfill what God has declared over our lives. And so, beloved, understand something. Everything has a particular purpose that is linked to a greater purpose. You have a purpose that's linked to a greater purpose. It's not just about you. And one of the things that I love is that my grandfather never got a chance to get on a plane, but his grandchild did.
All right.
You missing what I'm saying? In other words, when I'm being the first namesake that was able to graduate from college, not only that, but I never forget, you know something? I had to take a lie and tell my grandfather, because I'm a grandparent's child. I make no apologies about that. I was reared mostly by my grandmama and granddaddy. And so whatever they say, it went. And so, but then there came a place where I had to have righteous defiance. You'll understand that in a minute. In other words, there was an opportunity for me to go to Russia. And I came back home and I said, well, granddaddy, y'all, I want to go to Russia. And can y'all help me with some money? And they said, no, you can't go. I said, what? And so, but you know, they know this child. I'm with him. When something presents itself for me and it's something that's beneficial, I'm going to take it for what it's worth and move on. Not being disrespectful, granddaddy or grandmama. You ain't got to make it happen. And y'all, I went to Russia anyway. In other words, they didn't give me no money. I went with $11.35 in my pocket from yeah. Washington, D.C. to Russia. Stayed there for 2 weeks. Didn't have to worry about a place to stay, food to eat. Oh my, you know what I'm saying? But it comes back to you understanding your purpose. I didn't realize that that trip would have opened my eyes to see the world in a much bigger. But sometimes you gotta be careful who you connect with, because everybody may not always have your best interest because they wanna keep you close. See, his passport allowed him just to stay around there. My passport took me to the next level.
Yes, sir.
But you gotta know what's best for you. Young people, you gotta stop living for your friends and everybody else. You gotta start living for what you know God is calling you to, because there's some people that are assigned to your life that God wants you to pour into, that God wants you to speak into, that God wants to use you as a witness, because somebody had written you off, but God wrote you in because he had a purpose and a plan for your life. Purpose is permanent. Proverbs 19 and 21 reminds us, many are the plans in a person's heart, but it is the Lord's purpose that prevails. In other words, God has also given purpose. God has also given purpose, the quality of permanence, durability. It doesn't matter what you're going through. God has already purposed you to do what God has called you to do. And I didn't realize how much my purpose was connected to something even bigger, because even as a child, I can hear them say, oh, you're going to go farther than this. And I didn't know what they were talking about. And I didn't think about that until the time presented itself. Oh, you're going to do great and marvelous things. And I'm looking at them. This little boy from Bishopville, South Carolina is going to do what? Are you kidding me? I would never imagine. Here I am, one that has traveled to almost 14 countries and on the dime of the church.
Yes, sir.
But you got to understand something, that God has a purpose for your life. He's going to use you to get wherever you need to go, to get whatever deposit you need, because every place you go gives a deposit as well as it takes out a withdrawal.
Yes, sir.
And so, as you move forward, one of the things you need to be mindful of, that purpose comes with resilience. In other words, yeah, I was somewhat righteously defiant to my grandparents, but they understood it better. And it was interesting when I got back and the pictures got developed, and I began to show them where all I had gone. And Granddaddy began to marvel, because he would hear them talk about the Kremlin, but he never saw the Kremlin up close and personal. In other words, I'm the third generation, but the first one to go to school, the first one to be able to go over the water and come back without any hurt, harm, or danger. Yeah. I didn't understand that my grandfather was more concerned, because he comes from the World War II era where they didn't come back from the water.
Yes, sir.
But see, here's the thing. I had an opportunity to help him to see something greater that he would never see before. So in other words, young people, don't knock them because you think in their ignorance. No, just sit back and then begin to process and understand where they're coming from.
Yes, sir.
And so each comes with a different element. Purpose transforms mistakes into miracles and disappointments into testimonies. Let me help you understand something. And when I stop focusing on God and begin to do this thing on my own, now remind you, I said I got a chance to travel, to be a missionary, the whole nine. I went to 3 countries even before I left college. Come on, somebody. That's yes. That's a mouthpiece. And I didn't have to go to jail. God opened the door for me, and I'll never forget. When God has a purpose for your life, it doesn't matter what comes your way. When God says that you're going to do something, he will put everything in place, but it's up to you to receive it. It's up to you to walk in it. It's up to you to begin to seek out the understanding. And even if you go back and look at our text verse in Jeremiah 29 and 10 and 11 and even 12, it talks about seek out the Lord. In other words, you got to begin to seek God. God is the one that made you. God is the one that created you. God is the one that fashioned you. So you got to understand that your purpose transforms even mistakes into miracles and disappointments into testimonies. Everything that you've gone through, God uses it in order to prove that that's what my hand is upon you. I've called you. I've ordained you. It ain't always about preaching behind the pulpit, but it's about you walking in your God-given purpose, your God-given authority, your God-given power to be who God called you to be even before you were formed in your mother's womb.
Yes, sir.
Many of us, our problem is we're too busy trying to be a copycat versus being the original God called us to be.
See, come on.
So, beloved, even as you move forward, you got to understand purpose comes with the cost. In other words, P, that P means you got to begin to plan. In other words, he knows the plans that he has for you. He knows the thought that he's thinking towards you. In other words, you got to stop going to all of the naysayers and begin begin to go to the one who is the yesayer in your life. You got to begin to know how to look to the hill, get on your knees and begin to cry out to the one who is the planet of all plans, who is the one that is able to create you and keep you from falling. The one who's able to present you is going to require you to go back to him. That's what the P is in purpose. In other words, the U is for understanding. In all thy way, lean not to your own understanding, but in all, do what? Acknowledge him, and God will direct your path. But the question is, are you willing to move aside from your way and embrace the will of God and ask him to help you today?
Yes, sir.
But then it just doesn't stop there. It goes back to reason. You got to begin to understand reason. When the importance of a thing is not known, abuse is inevitable. In other words, don't abuse the power that God gives you.
Yes,
don't waste your purpose sitting there, as the psalm says, sitting on the dock of the bay. Wasting time and it just rolling away. You got to make every minute. Because the one thing we all get, a deposit every day you open your eyes, 24 hours. Mm-hmm. The question is, what do you do with them? How do you use them for the glory of God and whatever you're going through? Oh, let me help you understand this whole purpose. And the second key is for preparation. Preparation is the key to fulfillment of one's purpose. Go and be like the ant and not the grasshopper. And if you don't understand what I'm saying, my grandfather would always tell us when we're wasting time, stop being a grasshopper. And I'm like, granddaddy, why? In other words, the grasshopper was the one that was caught. And when the weather began to change, unprepared. In other words, you got to prepare. Be prepared at all time, because you never know when the opportunity will ever come again.
Yes,
because the ant was forever being diligent in preparation. You got to understand what the O meaning means, orientation. In other words, you got your P for planning. You got your U for understanding. You got your R for reason. You got your second P for preparation. But the O is for orientation. What you don't know would be greater than you. So get right orientation about your purpose. And it's interesting because I'm reading Rakim's book, and one of the things that he talked about growing up even as a 5%er, he said, I read everything that I could. I studied everything that I could. But you know, the church was always kind of like fuzzy to me. I didn't understand. But it wasn't until I came into the understanding of God for myself.
Yeah.
He had to reorient himself in the midst of who God is. In other words, you got to be clear about where you are in God for yourself. Don't allow somebody to tell you that you're closer to God or farther away. At the end of the day, it's what does God say? Mm-hmm. You got to know your orientation. You got to know your due north and move in that and allow God to lead you and guide you. So get right orientation about your purpose. Understand what God has said about your life. But then it moves on, not only just from the O, but the S. The S is for significance. Every person is built, every purpose is built on significance that differentiate you from the crowd. In other words, guess what? Yeah, I might look like a twin, but I ain't a twin. Come on now. Some of us, yeah, we all got our Gemini twins, but at the end of the day, be who God called you to be and not be ashamed. Because guess what? He bought you with the price. Nobody else did. Even though mama may have birthed you, daddy may have created you, but at the end of the day, God has the final say.
Yes, sir.
Be who you are. Every purpose is built on a significance that differentiates you from the crowd. Be who God called you to be. Be everybody else being you. You are the one who God called you to be without question. as you're moving forward. And so as we continue to move forward here, you got to understand purpose transforms your mistakes into miracles and disappointments, into testimonies. In other words, let me help you understand something. I need to come back and deal with that because I didn't have an understanding of being a person that was planning all the time. I wasn't always clear about understanding, and my reason was the right reason, and I wasn't always prepared, and I could care less about orienting myself and where God would have me. And so the significance was really what really mattered to me was everybody else and not what God was saying. And so guess what? Excellence is kind of went out of the window. So as I continued my journey throughout school and as I was embracing my purpose to embrace my call, I had nothing to worry about as it relates to finances because it was being paid for. But see, I started smelling myself, as they would say, at home and wanted to get in my own merry way. And something happens. That's when my scholarship got lost. And see, basically, I was already accepted in an accelerated program where I want to finish my master's in divinity in 2 years, unlike some of my other colleagues who would have taken three, but I wanted to go and do it my way. In other words, let me help you understand something. The purpose was still there, but I was more concerned about doing it my way versus God's way. In other words, when you begin to look to the hills and begin to embrace what God is telling you, you have nothing to worry about. Yeah, you got to walk through your valley moments, and you don't have to fear anything, for God is with you. But guess what? Because God said it, he watched over his word to perform it, and it shall not come back void. But when you step out of the will of God, you got some added pressures that are not good. So young people, you need to understand something. Be who God called you to be. Do what God asked of you to do. Say what God asked of you to say, and not worry about it. But sometimes you want to compromise because you're concerned about the crowd. Let me go back to my story. In other words, I have nothing to worry about in my journey for school. Everything was paid for because I didn't tell you that my daddy actually took the money because I didn't go where he wanted me to go. But God said, you're going to school. Come on, somebody. And because God said I was going to school, he opened the door for me to get another full ride. And I wanted to go to Morehouse. But God says, no, I want you at Clark Atlanta. But my journey led me through Spartanburg Methodist. I met a man by the name of Bishop James S. Thomas. He then in turn said, have you thought about Clark Atlanta? I said, no. I ended up going to Clark Atlanta on a full ride scholarship, ending up in an accelerated interdisciplinary program, which enabled me to get my undergrad and my master's in 4 years. You missing what I'm saying? But I didn't want to go the route that God was calling me to do, so I didn't want to go pursue an MDiv. I wanted to go get an MSW. In other words, I wanted to go get a master's in social work versus go getting an MDiv. And I didn't want to be nobody's preacher. I could care less about being somebody's preacher. I didn't see myself being behind the pulpit. I saw myself working in the field. In the field, not in the field, but in the field of serving people. I didn't want to be that here. And so I then in turn got grown. Ended up moving into social work, left the MDiv, and guess what? That's when the money dried up. Come on, somebody. But in the midst of it drying up, God taught me some things along the way because I purpose you. You can't abort your purpose. Remember, I said the purpose that God has for you is permanent. You can't get rid of it. I said that early on. And because I was willing to embrace what God had for me, I had to get to a place where I was broken. And say, okay, God, if you want me to do this thing, I'll do it for you. I ended up losing my house. I lost my job. I lost everything. But then when I said, okay, God opened the doors for me to become a missionary. And remember, I said everything, the good, the bad, the happy, and the sad, all of it works together. And that's when I really embraced my call and my purpose to move forward, to begin to challenge and to step forward. And guess what? When God did that, he then allowed my mishap, my mess, he allowed all of that to be a part of the journey, a part of my testimony. So beloved, as you move forward, embrace your purpose. Don't be ashamed about what God is calling you to do. It may not be called, you may not be called for you to be behind the pulpit. And it wasn't about me being behind the pulpit. I just came from a family of PKKs. In other words, they were preacher killers. I'll explain that to you the next time I come back. In other words, they sit around the table in the dining room after service and kill the preacher versus praying for the preacher.
Yes, love.
Come on now.
Talking now.
But not only do you have preacher killers, but you have those that have dream killers. Mm-hmm. Use the haters as stepping stones and not obstacles.
Yes, sir. Come on.
And if you don't believe it, I got some folk that can help you understand the journey. If you don't believe it, Moses, can you help me out? Because see, some of you have already given your excuses. I can't do this. I can't do that. Moses was the biggest stutterer there was. But in the midst of it, he brought his brother Aaron alongside him. I'm going to give you somebody to help get the children across this water to the promised land. And you don't believe it? Okay. My sisters, you don't believe that God has a purpose for your life, that even in the midst of your barrenness, come on, Hannah, can you help me out? Hannah was there barren for however long, but she continued to cry out unto the Lord. God used her barrenness to get someone's attention so that at the end of the day, when she got her child, she was able to give him back to the Lord and said, God, he's coming with the purpose you ordained for him. Auntie, let me help you. Come on, somebody. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, these five bad Negroes were caught up in a fiery furnace, but we didn't understand their purpose, but their purpose came clear. It was quite evident that even in the midst of them being willing to embrace what God is calling them to do, to have some fidelity about the God that they serve, they got thrown into a fiery furnace. But even that, Nebuchadnezzar had to bow down, because when he looked in, he saw four instead of three. Come on, you don't believe me? Let me call the roll just a little bit longer, because some of you have seen God moving and you've allowed Jezebel to intimidate you. Okay, Elijah, you saw what God did on the Mount of Carmel, but you allowed somebody else to cause you to try to abort your purpose. But when your purpose is real, you can't get there and say, God, take my life, and think that I'm going to take your life just like that, because I got a little bit more I want to pull out of you in this season. There are going to be some hard days as you embrace your purpose, but you got to hold on to what God is telling you, and know that sometimes you got to go back to them old hymns and hold on to God's unchanging hand, because the God that I serve is today, yesterday, and forevermore will never change, and you have to know that God is for you, and he will not against you.
Yes, sir.
So, beloved, I'm just reminded of one who's even greater than all of them. His name is Jesus. But something happens that he didn't turn volunteer and said, God, you know what? You have a purpose for that life. And so I will step out of time into eternity. I will go and sit here in all of your glory to going down there and being with them. I will dine with them. I will eat with them. I will walk with them. I will be tempted in every way so that they can then in turn have life and have it more abundantly this day. In other words, it's not just about the devil is saying, is about what you have already declared. You've already said that they are the head and not the tail. They are the lender and not the borrowers. You said that they shall have life in heaven more abundantly. But God, I understand that even me having to be born, placed in a swaddling clothing, placed in a trough, there's something good. There's a purpose there. But you just didn't stop there. You allowed me to come on down the road and tell John, come on and baptize me, because I got to begin my walk down the Via della Rosa, because there's somebody who needs to experience my blood, somebody that needs to be redeemed, because I am the one that will allow them to be set free from the sin and the bondages and the cares of life, because I know that in order for them to be free, I must die.
Yes, yes, yes.
There is no greater love than for a friend to lay down their life. That's love. He understood that he was the ultimate love, the ultimate sacrifice. He had his passport, and his passport moved him from eternity into time, back to eternity, for you and for me. Mm-hmm. He was clear of his purpose to die so that we could have life and have it more abundantly. He was clear of his purpose. His passport was stamped so that we could all have access, so that when he dies, guess what? He can say, well done, thy good and faithful servant, because you've been obedient to what God has asked of you. Beloved, if you don't do anything else, you got to embrace your purpose and move forward. Not allow anyone else to qualify or validate. God has already validated you this day. Go in purpose, go in promise, and go in the passion of Christ. For it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray. God, there's someone right now that is wrestling with their purpose. But God, just as Jacob wrestled with you, let him know it's okay. Let him know that it's okay to wrestle with you until you bless him. God, there's somebody right now that's wondering, God, what am I purpose for? It doesn't matter how young or how old, remind them that there's still purpose for for their life. It doesn't matter their age, it doesn't matter their pocketbooks, it doesn't matter at the end of the day, as long as they're breathing, able to comprehend that you have something for their life. And God, as they continue to look to the hills, knowing that their help will come from you and you alone, you reminded us, God, to seek ye first the kingdom of heaven. So God, forgive me because I've been seeking everything else, and so God, I'm going to look to you this day and allow you to lead me every step of the way. You speak to my heart as only you can do. God, allow your word to be made clear about who you called me to be. Just as Samuel went to Eli and said, okay, I hear this voice. And whatever the voice is, God, allow them, lead them, guide them, and direct them. For someone may need salvation, God, remind them. All they need to do is confess with their mouth and believe in their heart. They shall be saved. And so, God, it's not always about the church formulas, but at the end of the day, it doesn't matter if they're in Walmart or in the bathroom. Wherever you touch their heart, God, allow them to find that purpose first. And all of the other things shall be added unto them.
Yes, sir.
For God, we give you thanks and give you praise for who you are. For you have already done it, and it's already so. Now stamp my passport so that as I come before you at the end of the day, you can say, enter in, thy good and thy faithful servant. In your son Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Yeah. Amen.